The iridescent blue Wraith mortar tank is iconic and is an indisputably core part of the Halo franchise, which is why Mega hasn't made this version in 13 years and hasn't made any Wraith in 8 years. So 4 years ago, I set out to create the ultimate Wraith build that we all wanted. But that was 4 years ago, and a lot can change in 4 years. If you follow the channel, you'll know, as this build predates everything that you've seen so far. So let's see how this mock stacks up. This is the mock that restarted it all. I loved Halo growing up, and Megabox Halo came around just after I'd started to create some rudimentary vehicles using the garish colours in my LEGO collection. But inevitably, over time, I kind of drifted away and moved on to other things, until the event happened. So at that point, I kind of figured, hey, why not try to rekindle my mock making skills? So I hopped online and managed to find a bunch of used sets. With a very limited number of pieces, I set to work trying to make a build that was as accurate to the games as possible. I started by booting up Halo 3 and Halo Reach on the MCC. After looking at them both in a bit more detail, I found that I preferred the style of the vehicle from Halo 3, but the Halo Reach model just had higher textures and detail, so I ended up making a form of mongrel between the two. So the build ended up with the style and general colour scheme of Halo 3, but with a few of the added details from Halo Reach. In my eyes, this was the best of both worlds. So let's delve into the features including in this build. It was important for me at the time to get as many of the features of the vehicle into the build as possible. So there's a driver's hatch mechanism so it can slide back and forth, much like in the game. And it's tight, but there's just enough room to fit a driver inside the cockpit. There's a rotatable gunner turret that features a somewhat elevating gun that can, of course, fit a figure. The rear mortar cannon features a folding mechanism. First you slide the covers down, and then fold the back piece up and elevate the gun into its firing position. The front two side pods slash wings are hinged and can elevate and depreciate. Finally, these rear wing segments can somewhat rotate. Not really sure if that is featured in the game though. As you've come to know from some of my other mocks, I did my best at the time to pack as much detail into this as possible. In the game, you can see that there is actually a blue front detailing stripe, so I did my best to emulate that in the model. For this vehicle, one of the most key things to get done is to nail the general curvature, especially at the front segment of the Wraith. And although this is better than the set, in retrospect, I think that it curves a little late, so it definitely could be improved. I also did what I could to add some detailing between the pods. There are also these small wing segments that cover the pods on the in-game model. I did kind of add these in, although I think I went a little bit overboard with this one. There are some other areas that feature a small bit of detailing, like the wing flaps on the back of the side pods, and I'm happy with this little bit of detailing on the rear of the Wraith. And as this is the build that started it all, it also started the tradition of smoothing and detailing the underside. Now this did turn out far better than a standard set did, although it is using those short sword wings, but it lacks detail as it's just mostly smoothed off. So it's good, but it definitely could be better. Along with this, a lot of the mechanisms could do with some significant improvement. The front hatch mechanism, whilst cool, does easily get stuck and is quite finicky to move. And whilst the gunner turret is a really nice addition, the gun on the turret doesn't fully elevate, and the bottom part of the turret can conflict with the cannon covers. The mortar cannon mechanism, whilst accurate to the game, is fragile, which can make it quite frustrating to fold in and out. Whilst the droop mechanism of the front pods do work, sometimes the lower geometry of the pods conflict with the main body. This uncouples the entire mechanism and can cause it to essentially fall off. One final thing I want to mention is that I want to improve the curvature of the mock in general. Whilst this version is an improvement upon the original sets, I'd really like to make it a bit more seamless, as there are still a fair amount of gaps showing on this mock. So like I said before, this one was the mock that restarted it all for me. But it was far from perfect, especially when you consider that I wasn't working with that many pieces at the time. If you compare it to Mega's most recent similar set, the added curvature and the lack of steps just makes this build so much more believable. And I have no idea why Mega hasn't updated such an iconic design in so long. When comparing it to the 2012 set, this model improved upon the detail. This build is significantly more accurate to the in-game model and detailed than the original set. It comes with extra features. With the addition of the sliding canopy, this one has just slightly more features than the original set did. It features an enhanced gunner turret. One of the things that I was really happy with at the time was the solution that I came up with for the gunner turret. Whilst this isn't the most robust part of the build, it adds more believability to the MOC and is the most standout new feature. But of course, this is old now and is in need of an Ultimate Scale Series overhaul. So in general, I think that I could further improve the detail. There are multiple ways I think I could enhance a new Wraith design, especially when you consider how much more experience I have now. If I can use all the experience that I've acquired from the MOCs I've done since this, then I think there are so many areas that I could really cram more detail into. I also now have a much larger parts library. I'm aware that you're never going to be able to get every part in every color in every quantity, but having a larger parts library is an absolutely massive help. Being able to follow up any ideas you have without having to wonder if you have the right part will greatly help in making the next MOC as good as it can be. And finally, I think I could make better mechanisms in this MOC. My lack of pre-planning in the original design meant that a few of the mechanisms left something to be desired. I especially think that the front hatch might be able to be further improved, and the side pods could definitely have a much more secure connection. But what about you? What do you think? What areas do you see in this that could be further improved? And how do you feel about Mega not making a decent Wraith in more than a decade? Let me know below. Unfortunately, this is my last video in the Preforged series, but hopefully it won't be too long until I can get around to properly doing these Covenant vehicles justice. And there is something massive coming soon that I've been working on for literally years. So you're definitely going to want to subscribe to see that. And if you like this video, then maybe you want to check another one out too. Until then, I'm Reforger. Thanks for watching. And I can't wait to show you what's probably in the next video.